सर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका कि आपने प्रत्येक टीम के बारे में अलग अलग प्रकार से विचार रखे, कुछ टीमों का पंचनामा भी किया। और सर विषय के जो अनुवाद की बात है, ये अनुवाद हमने हिंदी डिपार्टमेंट के वरिष्ठ प्रोफेसर साहब से ही कराया था, इसमें कुछ गलती हो गई है, हम आगे से इसका ध्यान रखेंगे। आपके सुझाव के लिए धन्यवाद। अब मैं स्टेज टीम से अनुरोध करता हूँ कि वो वैलेडिक्ट्री के लिए स्टेज को रेडी कर दें।
Jamia Millia Islamia, in our annual fest, Ecocracy 2017, I give you all a very warm welcome and I thank you for your presence here. Now, it has indeed been a very intellectual debate that we just witnessed, and for its valediction ceremony, I would like to introduce to you all our guests. Our chief guest of the day is Syed Faisal Ali, ex-group editor of Sahara News. I request sir to please come up on the stage, and I request our joint secretary Irfan to please present sir with a memento.
Instituted the idea of an old books library in the Gaya Voice
orphanage, and he's extending this and he's inaugurating that library in today's events. And I'd like to request our guests for today to please open the presents in front of you to launch the library. The library has indeed been started in a very good cause, in a golden cause indeed. It is a Library, and in the spirit of the name that we conducted this debate in, I would like to invite our chief guest for the day, Syed Faisal Ali sir, to please come up on the dais and please say a few words.
for inviting me to this valedictory function of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam national debate on whether democracy has failed or not failed. So all of you have already spoken, and I think prizes have already been decided. But as Faisal Saab has just said, and I will also support him in this, that you see, if you study democracy in our country, particularly I am talking of India, since independence, this is one of the very important contribution of politicians in this country, that democratic institutions have survived. There may be some objections, there may be some points about efficiency of democratic system, whether we are 100% democracy or we are slightly less, or in some cases where there are allegations that democracy has been subverted. But by and large, I must say that democracy has survived in this country, and has not only survived, has kept the country united. This is one of the very important things, because India, being a diverse country, having different religions, languages, culture, different kind of people, 29 states, 9 union territories, so all of them we have been able to keep together only because of democracy. If there was no democracy, it was not possible to keep such a big country united. That is the one of the very important contribution of democracy. Here the government changes after the election process is over, and anybody losing the election just silently go and tender resignation. यहाँ ये नहीं होता कि वो एक मिनट के लिए भी ये सोचे कि मैं इस्तीफा ना दूँ या मैं कुछ और तरीके निकालूँ to continue in power. क्योंकि अगर वो होता तो इंडिया की डेमोक्रेसी has failed totally. कितने भी पावरफुल पॉलिटिशियंस हुए हैं हिंदुस्तान में, मगर अगर इलेक्शन में वो उनकी किसी वजह से विक्ट्री नहीं हो पाई है, तो वो within half an hour, 1 hour, they go and tender their resignation. They may say that there were bad practices, they may say anything else, but first thing they will do to tender resignation and allow the other people who have won the election to form the government. ये सबसे बड़ी तारीफ हिंदुस्तान की जमहूरियत की है. और आप लोगों ने अपने डिबेट में अपने ख्याल का इजहार किया होगा, इसके फेवर में भी बोले होंगे, इसके अगेंस्ट में भी बोले होंगे. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was also a firm believer in democratic system. He used to say the same thing which I said just now, that democracy has succeeded in this country, and this is the biggest contribution of democracy in our country. This I have written in my book also, quoting Dr. Kalam. So I wish you success in all your endeavors, all the students. And debating is a very important quality of your student. So apart from being you are studious and you should do well in your academic field, you should develop the habit of debate. That's a very good step, and you please continue this and keep on organizing debates on various issues so that new ideas emerge and you also become confident in your daily life and contribute better, in a better way, to the society, to the university, as well as to the nation. Thank you. Gracias.
Your kind words, sir. Next, I'd like to invite Mr. Hasibur Rahman to give his views on today's events. Thank you so much, sir.
Alaikum. It's indeed great pleasure to be with all the budding students here, full of enthusiasm, zeal and fervor. It's indeed great moments, especially against the backdrop of this very challenging topic that you all have got here and debated also. But we really missed all those thrilling moments when all of you were pitted against each other on this topic. So had it been moments for us also to be present during those moments, it would have been indeed exceedingly great pleasure for all of us also. So some of you must have spoken in favor of this topic, some must have gone against this topic. But as expected, S.M. Khan sir has pointed out that in our country, democracy has not faltered or has failed. on any of the fronts. Especially when there is a change of guard during the elections time, you will find that how smooth the transfer of power is. There is no bloodbath, there is no heart burning. Of course, heart burning is there. Some may complain against the ballot boxes and all, but it is a normal flow of the transfer of the power. So in our country, politicians are very much aware of the reality that is embedded in our soil. And if you recall the saying of Abraham Lincoln, the 16th President of the United States of America, I think politicians in our country are well aware of this reality. To quote, you can fool some of the people all of the time, some of the people, some of the time, but you can't.